In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create an auto-resizable text box, but the one issue that always comes up is how to animate the text box independently of the text it's enclosing, especially when using text animators. Well, I think I've cracked the code and I've never seen this done anywhere else, so I'm assuming you haven't either. There's a lot to get through, so let's dive right in. Okay, so I'm going to start off by just creating some text, and I'm using Gilroy Heavy, and I'm going to make this all caps and actually spell my name correctly. And then there are a few things we need to make sure of before we get too deep into this. Hold on Command or Control and double click the pan behind tool to center our anchor point, and just go to our line panel and just center that right up. If you go to your paragraph settings, make sure that this is left justified. If you right click on the layer, you can go to Effect, Generate, Fill. I'm going to go ahead and just change this color, like a blue, and this will actually be the color of the text box. Let's go over to our effects and presets and type in reptile, and we're going to add in a CC reptile. And now we're going to expand this 20 pixels all around. This is going to be the padding of our text box. Go back to our effects and presets and type in shift, and we're looking for shift channels. It's this right here under channel, so double click that. And this is really the part that makes this text box work. Go to this take alpha from, and it defaults to alpha, change it to full on, and now we have our text box. But we lost our text, so just type in CC composite and double click that, and we have our text back now. The thing that's really cool about this, if we go back to our character control panel, we still have control over the color of our text. I can change this name. This is my wife's name, Sheila McKnight. You pull this over here, and actually I'm going to reduce my size a little bit just so that way it stays in better. So we have our text box, and this is really cool. It will auto-resize. One of the things I would do at this point is make sure that your leading is set to the way you want it. So now let's duplicate this layer. I'm going to rename this top layer name, and then this second layer we're going to call box. Select both those layers, go to our finder and type in source. Pick whip the source from the box to the source to the name. And now I'm going to turn this name layer off just so you can see what it is I'm doing here. Our box still has our name on it. Select this fill, duplicate that, bring it underneath. We can change this to any color that we want. If we animate our name layer, we get some really funky results. And I'm going to show you really quick what I'm talking about. So let's turn off this box layer here. What if I wanted to animate this with a text animator? I have other tutorials that talk about text animators, so if some of this seems confusing, you can check those out. I'll put a link in the description below. But just really quick, I'm going to change this to ramp up. I'm going to increase my ease load to 100%. Our offset now, the range is from negative 100% is going to be our starting point. So put a keyframe, go forward just a little bit, and increase that. So what we have is something like that. So as you can see, the text box is moving with the text, and that's the main problem. So even if I go in here and I add in an opacity, and we'll bring that all the way down to zero, it affects our text, but not the box. So now what we want to do is take this box layer and parent that up to our name layer. So select the name layer, select all of these effects, and just get rid of them. All we need is the text. Now remember, we pick whip the source from the box layer to the name layer. The reason why I did that is because now, if I change this, say to Sheila McKnight, that's our text by itself, and our text box is moving with it because the source text from our box is linked to the source text of our name. We can animate our text in, and it doesn't affect our box. We can do that independently. Select Y to bring up your pan behind tool. Let's click on snapping right here. I'm just going to move my anchor point to the far left right over here. V to go back to our selector tool. S for scale and unconstrain these. Let's put a keyframe at the beginning of our animation. We'll make the X value 0. Shift page down 1-2 times to go for 20 frames. Now make this value 100. F9 to make that easy ease. Go to our graph editor and we're just going to pull this over. So now our text box animates in independently of our text, which is really, really cool. So we have complete control over this. I want to show you how you can really use this technique to add even more elements. I'm going to duplicate this box layer. I'm going to call this line. S to bring up our scale. Select scale so that way it selects both of these keyframes. Now make our Y value, we'll go all the way down to something like, we'll say 7. Bring up our position and we pull this underneath and we see we have this line. Now, it's a little bit thicker, and that's because of this reptile. This is our padding we have for this line. I just want to expand this left and right so we can take the expand down to 0 and expand up to 0. So now we have this really thin line. And since this box is linked to our name layer, see if we select both of those, type in source, we can see that this line layer is also linked up to our name layer because we duplicated the box. Since that's the case, now this line will animate and it will always be the same width as our text box. Let's retype this. It just gives you more control. You can do some really cool stuff with this. Offset this line and watch it play back, and we can see that we can even offset this animation. Maybe you want to make it a little bit slower, so the box comes in and then the name and then the line comes in after that. Now, one of the things I like to do whenever I do these lower thirds is I want my name to only show up in the box. So if you're in After Effects 2023, you can take this track matte layer, go down to box, make sure you turn the box back on. So now when it comes in, it will only show up in our box. One of the things that's common with lower thirds is to have a title. Go back over to our character panel and maybe make this 50. We want to go from heavy to a light font, and I'm just going to expand this. Let's go back to our name layer, and let's go ahead and grab our animator. I'm going to copy that and just paste it right onto our motion graphic design layer, so that way we have the same kind of animation. One of the things that I want to do now is have this line go the length of our motion graphic designer layer, and we can do that. If we go back to our line layer right here, this expand right, this is what controls this line right here. You can do a lot of really cool things with this. You're not just limited to just a text box that auto-resizes. If you select all those layers, we type source. Our line layer and our box layer, the source text is linked to our name text because the width of the line in the box is dictated by our name layer. One other quick thing you can do, you know that the repetile, this is responsible for our padding. See, we have this expand right, left, up, and down set to 20. If I want to change this, I have to go in here and change every value. So just something really quick, if you want to avoid that, right-click on this layer. Let's go to Effect, Expression Controls. We're going to add in a slider control. So let's go down to our layer here, and I'm going to hit E to bring up our effects, open up Repetile. Just link all of these to this slider control, because they're always going to be the same value for our box. Now, our line is going to be different because we don't want the height or width. Remember, we just want this to be very short and wide. But for the box, you can link that up to this slider control, call this padding. And as you can see, it already changed our padding because it was set to 0. So now, see if I make this value 10, it expands. We can see the effect of increasing this. Okay, so now one of the things that I did for our box layer right here, I'm just going to solo our box layer, is I duplicated this fill, and that way we have this second fill down here, and this is the color that's actually controlling the color of our box. You can actually get rid of this top fill. You don't really need that. What I should have said is just move the fill down underneath everything else, and your box will be set and good to go. And that's how you create an auto-resizable text box without using any expressions. I'd like to thank the good folks over at AE Juice for sponsoring this video. If you haven't checked them out at aejuice.com, I highly recommend you do just that right now. Get tons of free plugins from AE Juice that will save time while adding polish and professionalism to your projects. Get the AE Juice Starter Pack, which contains over 100 assets for your projects, including liquid and shape elements, liquid transitions, slides for your slideshows, text presets, flat icons, 2D and 3D assets, and so much more. AE Juice also offers professionally produced sound effects absolutely free. Other free plugins include a HUD package that is super cool. These elements would literally take hours to create, but with AE Juice, you get them absolutely free and they can be dropped into your project with the click of a button. Some of my personal favorite free plugins include Copy Ease, which allows you to copy the speed graph of your keyframes and paste them so you get identical keyframe speeds. I also use Shifter on a regular basis. Instead of going through the multiple steps of offsetting layers, this plugin allows you to do it with the click of a button, which saves a tremendous amount of time. In addition to these impressive free plugins, you can also purchase advanced products at more than reasonable prices. Take advantage of AE Juice's bundles. My personal recommendation is that you get the I Want It All bundle, which includes everything I just showed you. I've been approached by several sponsors, and I will not promote their products unless I support them, use them, and highly recommend them. AE Juice is an amazing product and company, and in my opinion, it's a necessity for any serious motion graphic designer. AEJuice.com. I hope this tutorial helped you out and that you learned something new and useful. Make sure to come back next time for another tutorial that will expand your knowledge of After Effects while also teaching you some really cool tips, tricks, and shortcuts. Please comment, like, share, and subscribe, and click the bell so you're notified every time I upload a new video. Support our channel by getting your 7-minute AE merch today at our online store. and sign up for my Udemy course, The Power of Shape Layers, is guaranteed to make you a shape layer rock star. The link to that course, to our 7-Minute AE store, and the project files for this episode are all in the description below. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.